We need answers.
I'm telling you, we should try and come up with a plan. We just need some financial backing. But, I mean, just like how they came up with Soul Plane, like, come up with an airline for kids.
Please.
Yeah.
Because if, and another thing, I'm going to tell you this.
Adolescent airlines.
This, whoa!
Look at that.
We better,
I'm already.
We got to trademark that. We got. Hey, y'all, don't even try it. We trademarking it. So.
Yeah, we just got to get some pilots and everything else. But
look,
don't steal my name.
We got excited about the name. Right. We don't have any planes yet, but don't steal our name. But for real, Telly, like, I cannot take just little kids everywhere that do not have parents who discipline them. And furthermore, if I see one more kid in first class,
ooh,
do you know how many Greyhound buses I
oh
took
my
as a child?
Gosh.
Like, flying was a privilege. It was a luxury when I was growing up. Like, if you got to fly, and you know, my grandmother, she would, a lot of times I would fly with my grandmother, and she would make sure that we are dressed to the nines, do you hear me, Telly? I'd have the Mary Jane patent leather shoes,
ooh, ooh,
the white socks with the lace, crushing it, fresh part with the pigtails. You know, my scalp is all greasy.
Oh,
all
got
good.
That grease,
man,
and your
got
scalp
that grease
shining.
Going. What? Had the hot comb all night. That's how we treated flying. Now you walk in onto the now, look, I've already been totally frustrated dealing with all these little kids everywhere in the airport. I get on the flight, I'm like, okay, peace. I'm gonna be able to sit in my seat, row one, seat F. And I look to my left, and there's two kids, and they're screaming, "Oh, I want the iPad! Give me the iPad! Oh, I had it first! I'm hungry! Can you?" Parents, please do not purchase first class tickets for your kids.
Or
don't even
purchase a drink for them. If you're Denise, and be like, hey, just take a little sip of that. And then by the time they take off, they out.
Excuse me, can I get some NyQuil? Here, little Johnny.
Here.
You want something to drink?
You want some sip candy with it too?
Right.
Next thing you know, oh, they're snoring louder than the doggone play.
I would rather hear snoring than a kid
yes,
screaming and crying.
Yes.
I cannot. All right, let's see. Damn, we got the heat already in the morning. This is the truth. Talking text line is 833-212-1017. Tim Scott is a liar. He said there is no racism in America. I really that came from Lion. Good morning, Lion. Thank you for listening, and thank you for the text. I'm gonna keep it real with you, Lion. It's Friday. It's 414 day. Let's just ease into it today. I really want to make sure that me and Telly kick off y'all's weekend on high, positive vibe notes, good vibes.
Yes.
So I don't even know if I'm gonna even use the word racism today. We talked about it a lot yesterday.
We did talk a lot about it yesterday.
Let's talk about fun things.
Yeah.
Here's the reality. Lion, I don't know your race or ethnicity, but if you are black, you don't need to be reminded. You're gonna probably deal with it sometime before the day is over. But so what are your plans this weekend, Telly?
My plans is usually just like yours, Denise. Just work.
Quack.
Yeah, but good work. I will be heading down to Chicago after the show, and I have a show on the Big Ten Network tonight at 10 o'clock, you know, shameless plug, and I also have a show tomorrow at 8 o'clock, so my weekend will be in Chicago.
That's right, because you're the two-time Emmy Award-winning Telly Hughes. I know, that's right. 10 o'clock now. What game... Oh, that's post-game at 10 o'clock?
Well, no, it's like a, it's called The Big Show. It's like a, somewhat like a sports center, but it's just centered around the Big Ten Conference. So now you have Big Ten baseball, softball season is in. You have a bunch of spring football games this weekend. And so, you know, your diehards really get pumped up for basically a dress rehearsal. But nonetheless, that's a part of the program, and so yes, that's what I'll be covering.
Very nice.
Yes.
Well,
what about
y'all,
you?
Y'all heard it. What am I doing this weekend?
Yes. Yes.
Well, first of all, definitely going to be napping today because I have a very light day. Go to the gym, work out. Telly, it ain't happening. It ain't happening, Telly.
Well,
I see your face.
That sounds like it's a good time to take a break, right?
Y'all, Telly, because if y'all knew what we talked about pre-show, I know what he's doing, and it's not happening. No.
Okay. It ain't going to happen this segment. But make sure you tune in, stay locked in, or Truth Be Told with DT and Telly.
Here at the new 101.7 The Truth, we count on the support of community partners. One of those local partners is Associated Bank. Together, we are committed to uplifting local organizations and supporting Black-owned businesses. We are proud to call Milwaukee home and promise to be a positive reflection on the community. We look forward to celebrating Black culture and excellence with you every day as we make history and continue to uplift the voices in our city. Join us for the journey at the new 101.7 The Truth, founded in partnership with Associated Bank, member FDIC.
Locked inside every Wisconsinite is a unique code that's shaped by your genetics, environment, and lifestyle. This code not only makes you uniquely you, it also holds clues as to whether you may be predisposed to certain illnesses like diabetes, cancer, or depression. And when you join the All of Us Research Program, you can get to know your health by receiving health information that matters to you. To learn more, visit allofus.wisc.edu or call 888-294-2661.
This is your Financial Empowerment Minute on the new 101.7 The Truth, presented by Northwestern Mutual.
You know how it is. In the financial world, same way within the sales or whatever, there's always this idea that this is a one-time offer. You just, if you do this today,
right,
then, you know, your whole, these sales will always come back. These things will always come back, opportunities. It's really important to try not to make financial decisions if you can the same day. Talk to some people that you respect, you care, you have high regard for. I think just not doing things the same day is important. It's so important you try to have at least a couple times in a month that you sit and think through your bills, okay, and where you're going. And another little small mindset hack that can work with this is to, before you make purchases, is this in line with my commitments?
Right.
But the question is, what are your commitments today? Well, same thing when you're purchasing things, right? You know, how is this decision going to be in line with my overall commitments or goals? It's just a little simple mind hack you can also do.
Tune into The Truth every month for our financial empowerment interviews with Northwestern Mutual.
For the brave men and women of the United States military, it has been said that some gave all, but all gave some. At Tabak Law, we honor these sacrifices by working to ensure veterans receive the benefits they're entitled to. I am Monica Ireland Karras. I am a partner and a VA-accredited rep at Tabak Law. If you're a vet and you have been wrongfully denied your veterans benefits, visit TabakAttorneys.com to set up a free evaluation. At Tabak Law, we fight for those who fought for us. Contact Tabak for the payback. TabakAttorneys.com.
Excited for a road trip? Start it off right with auto coverage from American Family Insurance. J.D. Power ranked us number one in customer satisfaction with the auto insurance shopping experience among mid-size insurers. Get a quote at AmFam.com.
American Family Insurance.
For J.D. Power 2021 award information, visit jdpower.com/awards. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, SI and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Truth Be Told with DT and Telly returns after this on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Yo, my men and my women.
You need something unexpected.
Yo.
Some form of weapon. You ask them to feel protected. And still feel protected. Just one time for the wreck it. Just one time for the wreck it.
You're listening to Truth Be Told with DT and Telly.
With the methods.
Coming to you live from the American Family Insurance Studio in the heart of downtown Milwaukee at the Avenue. We're going to have a great show today. Number one, because it's Friday. Number two, and even more importantly, it is 414 Day here in Milwaukee. Y'all know every April 14th, we celebrate our digits, 414. And Telly, Ben, I got to share with y'all a ton of great, great events that are taking place today, Friday, April 14th, to celebrate 414 Day 2023. Let me just run through some of them. And Telly and Ben, you tell me whether you swipe in right or left for any of these events, okay? We're going to do 414 Tinder. Truth be told, y'all going to get involved too. The Truth Talking text line is 833-212-1017. Madi, I see you. Happy Friday to you. So I'm going to go through these 414-day events. Telly, we'll start with you, Ben. Let me know if you're swiping left or if you're swiping right. Now, you know if you swipe left, that means what? You ain't feeling it.
Okay.
You swipe right.
I'm not a vet of Tinder, so I was just, I was, okay. So left is bad, you know, right is good.
Right is good. Right is, okay. Yep, I'm there. I would go. Okay, here we go. All right, the first is Gothic Milwaukee. They are going to release a self-guided GPS-based audio walking tour of Brady Street and the Lower East Side of Milwaukee today. Gothic Milwaukee, self-guided tour. Through your phone. What?
I'm swiping right. Ben?
I don't know. It sounds a little interesting. I mean, sounds like something to do here in Milwaukee. I don't know.
Okay, you swiping left or right, Ben?
I'll like the post. That's what I'll do. I'll like it.
You'll like it? Okay. So you're not either swiping. You say, I'll like
it. Yeah, I'll like it and keep scrolling.
All right. Now, this is one I would definitely swipe right. So, today, the Harley-Davidson Museum is only charging, you got it, $4.14 per person to visit the Harley-Davidson Museum when you buy it online. So, go to the Harley-Davidson Museum website, and you can purchase an admission ticket per person for $4.14. Telly?
Oh, I'm definitely swiping right.
Yeah.
That's one of the best museums in the country, and it just happens to be in the 414 in your backyard. And people, you got to realize, people come from all over the world to check out the Harley-Davidson Museum, especially gearheads, you know, the motorcycle heads or whatever, the riders. So,
and the anniversaries this year, too. Was it the big 150?
Oh, it's 150 this year. Oh, boy. There's going to be tons of people.
Truth Nation, let me know if I'm wrong, but yeah, it's going to be. Now, look, here's the bonus, though. So I'm glad you swiped right, because when you go to the Harley-Davidson Museum today, one of my favorite restaurants in Milwaukee is the Motor Bar and Restaurant. So at 3 p.m., the Motor Bar and Restaurant will give a free 99 Wisconsin State Fair ticket. First 120 people to visit the Motor Bar Restaurant, which is right next to the Harley-Davidson Museum. It's on the campus. You're going to get a free ticket to the Wisconsin State Fair. Also, there's more. At the Motor Restaurant, you can purchase a burger. And let me tell y'all, these burgers at Motor Bar Restaurant are delicious. You can purchase a special 4.14 pound burger for, guess what? You got it, $4.14. So definitely, you swiped right. Y'all made the right decision. Now, here we go, another one. You can see the 414 flags, the Milwaukee flag, be unfurled directly at City Hall before shopping at 414 Milwaukee. So the 414 flag will come down from the top of City Hall this morning with Bel Air Cantina, and Fuel Coffee, Ben and Telly. You'll get breakfast burritos and coffee for free.
At $3.99.
Well, no, Bel Air is going to provide the burritos, and Fuel Coffee is going to provide the coffee as you go to City Hall and watch the 414 flag come down from the top of City Hall. Left or right, what you swiping?
Anything free, you got to swipe right. You got to swipe right.
$3.99, you can't go wrong.
Yes, you got to swipe. And that's at 8 o'clock. We want to remind anyone that wants to go out there, that is 8 a.m. So truth be told, it'll still be going on. So make sure you stream us while you go out there and get your free food.
Absolutely. All right. We got about two more. You ready?
Here we go,
Ben and Telly. You can today secure tickets to cheer on the Brewers at AmFam for guess what? Only $4.14. The Milwaukee Brewers are going to be selling tickets today beginning at 10 a.m. until 11:59 p.m. tonight for their upcoming series against the Detroit Tigers. So, again, the tickets will be available for $4.14. And they will be in the terrace level, so don't get it twisted. You ain't going to be, like, sitting in the dugout. But it's, what is it again? It's free 99. Tickets are first come, first serve. So remember to go to brewers.com/flash, F-L-A-S-H, beginning at 10 a.m. So once you finish listening to our show, go get your breakfast, go kiss the kids or tell them that you love them through a text, and then go to brewers.com/ and get your tickets for the Detroit Tigers series coming up. You swiping left or right?
I'm swiping right. $4.14 for a Major League Baseball game. Even if you don't like baseball, you could go get three tickets for my math isn't that good, but I was at $16 or something like that. So if you don't even want to go, give them away. This is a good
exactly.
chance to be, you know, to give gifts, and especially when they're under $5. So, Ben, what up?
Hey, all I'm going to say is, look, everything that you guys put down today, Milwaukee always has something going on, and this is what I love about Milwaukee. I mean, the sun is shining right now. I think it's going to hit like 80 degrees or something like that today. My God, go see the Brewers. Pull up on Harley Davidson Museum. All right, and then, I mean, even that shameless plug that you put out there, Denise, as far as the food goes at that spot that you're talking about. That's crazy.
We got one more.
I know.
Go ahead, I'm sorry.
Gonna be good at some point today. That's all.
Oh yeah, you can. We gonna eat good today in Milwaukee. It's 414 day. I mean, seriously, all you gotta have is like a $5 bill, and you can legit eat really good today. Now, if you're not so much into baseball, but you love our Milwaukee Admirals, our hockey team, they are also celebrating 414 Day. And I love this, Telly and Ben. They're going to be honoring healthcare workers in our community by offering tickets for only $4.14 that will then be donated to Milwaukee healthcare workers and their families. So go definitely support this. Go out and get some tickets from the Milwaukee Admirals. They will be honoring 414 Day by supporting and honoring our local healthcare workers and their families. This is just so dope.
Yes.
What are y'all doing? Y'all swiping right or left?
Definitely swiping right on that. Shout out to our local healthcare workers. And it's not just during the pandemic where you were important and essential. You're essential and important every day, and they should be honored. And I'm actually going to hate a little bit. Love that the Admirals are doing $4.14, and it will be donated to local healthcare workers and their families. It should be $14.14 if you know you are donating to such a great cause and to the families of these local healthcare workers. But with the theme of 414 Day, $4.14, awesome deal to go check out the Milwaukee Admirals.
I feel you on that, Telly, because actually, let's just say we're going to add the U.S. area code. So the 1, the 4, and the 1-4. Now, here's my favorite part, and I'm swiping right on this. Let me just say this. I tell people all the time when I travel about one of the main reasons why I love Milwaukee is because when the sun is out, there is so many great music events. So if you're not so much into sports and you're more into art, performing art, as well as visual art, The Outsider, which is going to be hosting on the 9th floor of the Kempton Journeyman Hotel, which is located in the 3rd Ward of Milwaukee. They are hosting a fundraising event that will feature Milwaukee artists, musicians, DJs. They're going to have drinks from 2 p.m. Are you ready for this, y'all? This is crazy. This is why I love Milwaukee. From 2 p.m. and until 2 a.m.
Wow.
So we know that whenever it's hot in Milwaukee, and it's Friday too, and it's 414 Day, you're probably going to get about 2% productivity out of us if we're working. So
you
take
so
off
right.
early. Oh, yeah. We all taking off early today. So you can go to the Kempton Journeyman Hotel, and that is located in the 3rd Ward of Milwaukee, and just watch some amazing performing artists, visual artists, musicians, DJs. Get your drink on responsibly.
Great rooftop.
From 2 p.m.
Yes.
On the rooftop. It's going to be how warm is it going to be today, Telly?
I thought I saw a high of like 76, which
That's
means
what I'm talking about.
Like over the last couple of days, couple of nights, Denise, you want to talk about some perfect Milwaukee summer nights that we have experienced in April. It's still 58, 60 degrees at 9:30, 10 o'clock at night. And so, like you said, from 2 p.m. to 2 a.m., you're going to get great weather all day, all evening, all night long. So the Kempton Journeyman Hotel, there's so many things going on right now.
Cooperage is going to have a ton of performing artists as well. So definitely check out Cooperage.
Yeah.
Today is going to be dope.
Gosh.
It's going to be a fire emoji day.
Yeah, it's so hard to figure out what you want to do because there's so many things, and that's a really good problem to have.
It's a great problem to have. And so whether you are single, whether you're dating, whether you're married with children, 414 day is all about making sure that no matter who you are, your social economic background, your race, your ethnicity, your sexual orientation, your spirituality, whatever makes you who you are, today is about celebrating the people, places, and spirit that make this city unique. Go out and celebrate with yourself, with your loved ones, however you want to celebrate it, but make sure that you celebrate 414 Day, because Milwaukee is a unique city. We've got 80-degree weather, April 14th. Go celebrate. Go celebrate.
Yes.
Go celebrate Milwaukee and celebrate the fact that you are a part of this great city and you make this city great by being a resident. I'm so excited. It's 414 Day.
414 Day. It only comes around once a year, so enjoy it. And it's very rare that you have the type of temperatures that we will experience today on 414 Day. So make the most of it. Denise just ran down a list of things and options that you can have on this 414 Day in Milwaukee. And I wish I was going to be around a little longer. I may try to hit up a little something, Denise, before I leave to go to Chicago. This isn't a normal Friday.
Telly, I am telling you right now, go get that 414 burger at Motor Restaurant. I'm telling you. It is life-changing.
You know the problem with that, Denise.
Oh, you don't eat meat.
That's right.
That's right.
Maybe they got a good veggie burger.
I was going to say, maybe they have an Impossible Burger.
Yeah, yeah. I will check it out. And look, it's the best day to do it for $4.14.
Yeah, look, so even if you owe somebody money, you know, like when you owe people money, you don't want to go out. They'll be like, how you out and you owe me money? Today you get a pass.
Right.
Because everything is $4.
Like, look, I'm still struggling, dog.
Right. Look, man, I'm only, I know I owe you money, but today is 414 days.
Right,
so
can I get you a burger? Then you offer, I know I owe you some money, but can I get you a burger?
It reminds me of that scene in the movie Pursuit of Happiness with Will Smith. Uh-huh. And obviously he was struggling financially,
mm-hmm.
and he was taking care of his younger son. And one of his friends apparently had borrowed like $15 or $20
years prior. That money.
And he was like, bro, I helped you move last week. I thought we was good now. I was like, that is so us. That is so us. Dude, I walked with you to the park the other day. I thought we was even.
Like,
so
bro, I thought we were good. Like, I changed your oil and you walked to the store with me. Like, I thought we were good, man.
Oh my gosh, my stomach hurts. That's hilarious. Well, here's the thing. In addition to 414 Day, we are so thrilled and excited that you're joining Truth Be Told with Telly and DT. The headline we're going to talk about today. So apparently, we've been talking about the increase in gun violence among young folks here in Milwaukee. And Milwaukee leaders, including the police chief, as well as the mayor, saying they will not tolerate organized disruptive behavior, not even just disruptive behavior, but organized behavior. We'll talk more about that. Governor Evers has issued a state of emergency due to the wildfires that are taking place in the state. How does this impact our safety and health? And how will the increase in hot temperatures impact these wildfires? And what does that mean for Milwaukee? Also, it's financial literacy month here at 101.7 The Truth. We're going to be providing everyone tips on recovering, and I know this is something that I had to recovering from overspending and bankruptcy. And let me just share this with each of you. Some of you may have either experienced bankruptcy, going through bankruptcy, know somebody's going through bankruptcy. oftentimes you feel, man, I'm so ashamed, I'm so embarrassed. There is recovery. You can recover from bankruptcy, and you can recover from overspending. So we're going to share some tips on how you could do that. You do not have to feel embarrassed. Also, U.S. authorities will not pursue charges in the death of Shaquella Robinson. If you're not familiar, we're going to talk about who that is and why the U.S. authorities are not going to pursue charges in her death. It is Friday. It's 414 day. You are listening to Truth Be Told with DT and Telly on the new 101.7 The Truth.
Carrie, where's Tori Lowe and Dr. Ken at? I'm trying to knock these commercials out.
How am I supposed to know, Sherwin?
Well, I'm about to do their parts because my impressions are on point anyway. This is Dr. Ken Harris from Truth in the Afternoon, and I want you to download the Truth app in the Google Play Store and Apple Store so you can never miss my show or any of the award-winning 101.7 The Truth. Really, Kyle?
Sherwin, you are crazy.
Sherwin, your impression of me is horrible. Move. Give me my mic. I guess I'll just repeat what Sherwin said. Go to the Google Play Store or Apple Store to download the 101.7 The Truth app today so you can take the home of Milwaukee Black Talk with you wherever you are.
Can't listen live? Download the new 101.7 The Truth app on your smartphone today to catch up on all your favorite shows. Search 101.7 The Truth on your Google Play Store or Apple App Store so you don't miss out on any of the action.
Families in the 53206 zip code, join Milwaukee Public Schools for their Our Lights Are On community open house and job fair on Wednesday, April 19th from 5:30 to 7:30 p.m. at Douglas Middle School, located at 3620 North 18th Street. Meet community partners, apply for jobs, and enroll your child for the fall of 2023. There will also be free hot dog and chips for every attendee. Sign up today by registering at 53206april2023.eventbrite.com.
When it comes to riding the bus, there's a better way to pay. It's WISCO, Milwaukee County Transit System's new modern fare collection system. WISCO is available as a card and in the UMO app, and is packed with features to make paying for your rides faster, easier, more reliable, and more affordable. So make the switch to WISCO and start enjoying the better way to pay. Learn more about the exciting changes at ridemcts.com/WISCO or download the UMO app.
The next disaster is coming. The time to get ready is now. Make a plan. Identify meetup locations and people you'll need to contact. Put your contact list in your wallet, on your phone, and somewhere visible in your home. Build a kit. Store enough food and water for 3 days. Don't forget your pets. And consider buying a pre-made kit. Keep at least 7 days of medication on hand. Work with your pharmacist and insurance company to secure the extra doses. Make copies of important documents. Keep them on your phone, in the cloud, or on a USB stick. Stay informed. Learn about local hazards. Take courses in CPR and first aid. And sign up for local alert systems. An early warning can give you the time you need to prepare for a fast-moving disaster. Be ready. Learn more at americares.org/sendusin.
Through all the construction zones on 41 and 43. And check on the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast today. Mostly sunny with a high of 73 at the lakefront, 82 inland. Tonight, mostly clear with a low of 53. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga on 101.7 The Truth.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 101.7 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Brandon Snide. Behind a Rowdy Tellez two-run home run in the first inning and a sacrifice fly in the top of the 10th inning, the Brewers go on to win in San Diego, beating the Padres by a final score of 4-3. Colin Ray, who got the spot start for the Brewers, was the story of the game, going 5 2/3 innings while only giving up one earned run and striking out six batters. The Brewers are back at it tonight in San Diego. Eric Lauer is slated to start. First pitch is set for 8:40. Over to the NBA, where the Milwaukee Bucks are gearing up for their playoff run as they await the winner of tonight's play-in game between the Chicago Bulls and Miami Heat. Winner of that game moves on to Milwaukee for a Sunday afternoon tip beginning at 4:30 at Fiserv Forum. This sports update is brought to you by Associated Bank, proudly supporting your hometown teams. Member FDIC.
Truth Be Told with DT and Telly returns after this on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
Welcome back to Truth Be Told with DT and Telly. April is Financial Literacy Month, and The Truth has you covered on learning about how you can best manage your finances. Every Wednesday in April at 8 a.m., Truth Be Told will be joined by a representative from Educators Credit Union to discuss financial strategies to help you best manage your finances. That is every Wednesday this month on Truth Be Told with DT and Telly at 8 a.m.
Speaking of Financial Literacy Month, and I love that's why I love being a part of the Truth Team, because we want to make sure that we are equipped with the knowledge to win. Speaking of that, before we took a break, we were talking about recovering from overspending and even bankruptcy. Many of us know someone who has filed bankruptcy or is currently in bankruptcy. We may be in it. Do not think that life is over. Do not be embarrassed. Anytime there's a problem, there's always a solution. So we want to provide you some tips, because with the inflation, with potential recession in this country, and the fact that we are still recovering from the pandemic and still being impacted, there are ways that you can not only recover, but going forward, make sure that you have what you need to be financially equipped. Now, the first thing is this. Start with your young relatives. It starts at an early age. Start having conversations with your younger relatives, your kids, nephews, nieces, cousins, about saving aggressively. I didn't just say save, saving aggressively. Because even if you, let's just say you make less than $50,000 a year, there's still the reality that you can just take something out of your income and put it aside so that it's starting to work for you. That's the power of saving, because that money will begin to work for you. Not everybody has access to a 401k. I get it. There's always Bank of a Mattress. Okay, you can always use Bank of a Mattress. Next, learn to say no to your friends. Telly, I know this is big for me, because part of being social oftentimes requires to go out. And when you go out with your friends, like you said yesterday, I couldn't pick up and just go to Freaknik in Atlanta out of, you know, being a young kid raised in East St. Louis or growing up in East St. Louis. So you had to say no. And quite frankly, even as adults, we're going to have to start learning the power of saying no. It is okay to say, you know what, I'm gonna stay home, y'all. Y'all go ahead and have fun.
Here's okay. Yeah, I was about to say, here's a good saying, an old saying I know my mom used to say: just because you could do something doesn't mean you should do it.
Ooh, that's great advice.
Just because you can afford to do something, just because you still have the ability to do something, doesn't always mean you should do it. And that's where that powerful word that only has two letters in it,
and is this, it can be said anywhere in the world, and people will understand what it means.
Nah,
no matter where you go,
nada, ain't happening. And like all those things, you can use all of those terms to your advantage.
Next, and Telly, I just have a feeling you're very, very good at this. I just started getting good at this probably about, I'd say, 5 years ago. Set a budget, and also, because, you know, part of Financial Literacy Month here at The Truth, we partnered with Educators Credit Union. And every Monday, we have representatives that are giving us tips on how to build wealth, how to be financially literate. And so seek out guidance. You do not have to do this alone, but it is so important to create and stick with a budget. There are so many tools, Telly, that I use online where you can download templates and you can add your income as well as your expenses, anything like mortgage, rent, utilities, as well as money that you have coming in.
Yeah. Well, Denise, I tell you, even in our short time and with this show, not only the representatives from Educators have come in and schooled me on a lot of things, but you have as well. And I think that is another reason for people, for Truth Nation to really tune in when this free knowledge is being given out, and you can listen, and you can say, I mean, because I know there's been several times I'm like, oh man, I never thought of that, or wow. I mean, even the questions that you were asking the Educators representative on Wednesday about just having a personal relationship with your banker, how important that is. I've been with Bank of America for over 25 years, and I have never known anybody at Bank of America. And
you're not alone.
I mean, I just realized, I was like, wow, that makes a lot of sense. But you don't really think of it that way. It's like, look, I need to deposit this check. Let me go ahead and do what I need to do. And then I don't need to talk to you. As a matter of fact, if I can get an automatic teller, an auto teller, that's even better. But just establishing those relationships and them understanding, because guess what? If Denise Thomas is going through a certain period and it may be a little struggle, you could go to your banker and he knows your history and be like, okay, all right, Denise, you normally this is going on right now. We may be able to give you a little something just based off of our relationship.
Yeah, that happens. That has happened to me multiple times. And what I love about the benefit of building a relationship with a banking representative, or they call it the customer service representative at your bank, is that they are privy to information before it becomes public, i.e. PPP loans during the pandemic. There are so many programs that banks put together specifically for members of the brown and black community. Access to home loans, mortgage loans that you think are only for people who have great credit or people who have all this abundant amount of money. No, that's why it's so important to build a relationship. Also, before we move on to our next topic, please, it is so important, in addition to creating a budget and saying no, also seek guidance. You know, that's why we have this information, but don't just wait on us. Start a relationship, not just with your bank, but also consider a financial planner.
Yes, yes.
They're not expensive at all. And usually if you work with your bank's financial planners, that's part of the service of being a member of that bank or having an account at that bank. So definitely when you go to the bank, it's Friday, you may be going to the bank today, just pop your head in one of the customer service representative's office and say, you know, you got a second? Want to talk to you. If not, make an appointment, but definitely create and sustain a relationship with your bank's customer service representatives or financial planners.
Yes.
We want to win.
Yes, because knowledge is power.
We want to eat.
Yeah, because like it's one thing to say that. You're absolutely right, Denise. Everybody wants to eat. Everybody wants the bag, but we want to help you keep the bag. We want to make sure that you can sustain eating and not just you're eating for, you know, a few months and then it's all bad.
We want you to eat after 414 day.
Exactly.
Because the prices will go up. Yesterday's price will not be effective tomorrow, okay? Let me make that clear. It is one day, 414. Madee, she's loving the bank of a mattress. Now, look, I'm going to keep it real with y'all. With all these banks stuff going on, what's that saying? Don't put all your eggs in one basket?
Yeah.
Now, let me also give you a tip, Telly, on what I do. I use Bank of a Mattress, and let me tell you why. Because my mother is West Indian. She's Guyanese. She's from Georgetown, Guyana. And she would always say, "Gal, don't put all your money in one bank." And I'm like, okay, like, you want me to open some more accounts? My mom was like, no, Bank of a Mattress. Okay. Hey. It's open 24/7, 365.
And all you need is
there's
a few
no
strong all you need is a few strong rubber bands that you can get from the mailman.
That's all you need is strong. Now, I did kind of get a little sophisticated and went from Bank of a Mattress to a safe. So
That's that bouginess. That's that success coming out. Black folks don't have safes.
Yes, we do.
No, you don't. Black folks don't have safes. I mean, how many times you hear somebody rob a house and be like, you know, and it's a black person now, you're like, you know what? We went for the safe. No.
Hey,
ain't this still the butt-naked truth? Come on, Denise. Like, so I'm going to call you out on that one.
Truth Nation, truth talking tax.
That's that upper tax bracket type of movements.
Okay, let's
safe.
This is truth be told. You know what? The talking text line is 833-212-1017. Please, y'all, Truth Nation, please don't leave me hanging. Who else has a say? Look, Craig. See? Craig on the thank you, Craig.
Hey, Craig says, hey, Craig, all right, since you want to text in, tell us what type of line of work you in.
Oh my God. Y'all, we got more to come. We're going to have a great, great rest of the show today. Telly is on one today, but thank you. And he says his brother has one as well. You are listening to Truth Be Told with DT and Telly on the new 101.7 The Truth. We will be back.
Truth Nation, this is the effective communication coach, Denise Thomas.
And Emmy Award winner, Telly Hughes.
We are so excited to be your new host.
And we will continue to have real and authentic conversations while brightening your morning and giving you something to smile about.
So, Milwaukee, join Telly and I every weekday from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. for Truth Be Told on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth.
Your first time biking to work. Your new helmet? Secure. Your bike? Road ready. You got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with Access Checking, it's maintenance fee-free with no minimum balance requirements. So even if down the road that bike needs a little maintenance, at least your checking account won't. You've got this with Access Checking from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
It's time for Truth Takes, a thought-provoking commentary on the new 101.7 The Truth. Here is Dr. Ken Harris with his truth.
A recent survey question at work asked, who's your best friend at work? My reply, no one. You know, it came to me, I've never had a best friend. I remember I had a best friend, but I wasn't his best friend. I initiate hanging out today, you know, doing the bro thing. I don't get calls like, hey, let's go hang out. Let's go do stuff. And don't start calling me because you feel sorry for me. I'm not a crybaby snowflake. I'm content hanging out by myself. I grew up behind in 4 important statistics: education, income, investments, home ownership. Not seeing these things in my life. I grew up poor. Today, I'm a step ahead of many of my peers, and that's where the road forks and the clock started. See, I set people and organizations on a clock. When the buzzer rings, I'm tapping out. I don't waste good things, education, income, intellect, wisdom, advice on people who won't appreciate them. Matthew 7:6 warns us to give not that which is holy unto the dogs, neither cast ye your pearls before swine, lest they trample them under their feet and turn again and rend you. Life made me tough. I've heard people say, he doesn't have feelings. I do. I learned not to share them because I'm making sure my life doesn't end up like everybody else's, trampled underfoot.
This has been Truth Takes on the new 101.7 The Truth. Listen to The Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris, weekdays from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m.
Truth Be Told with DT and Telly returns after this on 1017 The Truth, The Truth App, and 1017thetruth.com.
Why they wanna stick me for my paper? Damn. Why they wanna stick me for my paper? Damn. Why they wanna stick me for my paper? Damn. Why they wanna stick me for my paper?
Speaking of paper, one call, that's all is right. Now is your chance to be entered to win our one call, that's all 5K giveaway. Yeah, you heard it right. $5,000. Be caller number 3. We're gonna make it caller number 3 today, Ben, right now, and be entered to win $5,000. Remember, if you or a loved one has been injured in an accident, call Gruber Law Offices now. One call, that's all. Be caller number 3 and win this money from the One Call, That's All 5K giveaway. For official contest rules, visit 1017thetruth.com or call now at 833-212-1017.
And when you win the $5,000, go put it in your safe. Contrary to popular belief, and we were, if you're just tuning in, this is The Truth Be Told with DT and Telly. And we were talking about ways that you can recover from overspending or even in the midst of bankruptcy. And I was sharing with Telly that in addition to having accounts with banks, I want to make sure that if anything happens with any of the banks that I have accounts in or with, that I still have access to capital, to money, to cash, to moolah. I said I have transitioned from keeping money in bank of a mattress to now a safe. Telly says, black people don't have safes. I'm like, yes, we do. We have safes. Let me tell you why I purchased a safe. As a single woman during the pandemic, there were some images, Telly and Ben, that I was seeing that just were a little intimidating, for lack of better words. And I felt that as a single woman, I needed to make sure that I had, let's just say, some defense mechanisms, some tangible defense mechanisms. And so I went and, handled my business with the state of Wisconsin so that I could be protected. And then I went on Amazon.com and purchased a safe and made sure, again, that in the case of an emergency, I have access. Do we have a winner?
We have a winner. Geraldo is our winner. Yes, sir. Yes. And Geraldo gets a chance to enter the $5,000 giveaway. Geraldo was our third caller. Thanks for hitting us up, Geraldo, and congratulations. But yes, so I know we're getting to a break here, Denise, but yes, I know you want to kind of, put a bow on this black people in safes. And and once you told me why.
Nike shoebox.
Yes, or the Nike
shoebox.
Or the Nike shoebox.
That's the real safe right there, Ben. Everybody got a Nike shoebox. Oh, no. The Crown Royal bag. Hey.
Oh, everybody had the Crown Royal bag. Oh, my gosh. If you didn't have a Crown Royal bag, you wouldn't lie. You wouldn't about them streets. But we'll have more conversation on the other side of the break. Hour number 2 coming up, Truth Be Told with DT and Telly.
Truth Nation, the locations are set and it's time to clean up our city. Join me and the Truth team on Saturday, April 29th for our community cleanup. Go to truthcommunitycleanup.com to volunteer and help keep Milwaukee clean. Everyone who joins gets a Truth shirt, a bucket hat, and a free lunch. The Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored by St. Anne's Center, the best intergenerational care in Milwaukee.
Hey, Truth Nation, just press play. Your favorite award-winning 1017 The Truth is launching our brand new video stream this Friday. Watch live on The Truth's Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook pages. Just press play this Friday for the home of Milwaukee Black Talk.
This is Dr. Ken Harris from Truth in the Afternoon. Listen to The Truth all day, every day by downloading the Truth app or streaming on Spotify, TuneIn, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, or Stitcher. Milwaukee Black Talk, 1017 The Truth.
Kids across America are going to school hungry. Millions of kids every day. Hungry kids get sick more often. and can struggle in school. It can be harder for them to focus and learn. But one simple thing can help change all of this for a hungry child in America. Good healthy food and the energy it brings. With help from caring people across America, No Kid Hungry is providing healthy meals and hope to hungry kids so they can build better futures.
We want to ensure that all of our kids have healthy meals every day.
Thank you.
Thank you for helping feed our kids.
To learn more about ending child hunger in America, go to helpnokidhungry.org today.
We didn't know what to expect. We were just left in a hotel.
My mom was doing drugs in the house.
Tay and Brianna spent years of their childhood in homes that weren't safe. They were placed in foster care and longed for a permanent, loving home.
I didn't know what my future was.
I wouldn't speak to anyone. I was afraid of everything.
With help from the Dave Thomas Foundation for Adoption, Brianna and Tay were adopted and now feel excited about their futures.
I'm studying to be a chef, and I really want to travel the world.
I'm going to be a mechanic, and I can focus on my career.
Right now, in the United States, there are more than 100,000 children in foster care, just like Brianna and Tay, who need a family now. Learn how you can help at DaveThomasFoundation.org.
Truth Nation, stand up and tap in. This is 1017 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha and W269 DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station. Truth Be Told with DT and Telly returns after this on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
And now I'm here, and you're sitting there cold stairs, wishing was here. When back then I'd be right there, but I had a little treat myself bad, cause you never could've. And ever since, I chose to stay true. Say motherfucker me, no motherfucker you. You couldn't trust me, I couldn't trust you, but you never should've. And now I'm here, and you're sitting there cold stairs, wishing was here. When back then I'd be right there, but I had a little treat myself bad, cause you never could've. And you never woulda, cause I have to take shots if you ever coulda. And a couple K dots and a couple J rocks. I watch a top dog like a tank top, and it's on push the stars, quick clean. This is how we push the art on tickin' toss. Spent hours on my wrist to watch. You can't burst 1 second. Let me fix my claw. Me and my ex undressed, had a menage a trois. We had sex with our best friends, blah, blah, blah. We had made a little film, we had went too far.
To truth be told with DT and Telly, it is Friday, April 14th. It's also Milwaukee 414 day. Telly Ben. I'm so excited. Now, we've got in our second hour, a lot of interesting things continue to happen. But I do want, before we get into the lighter things, I do want to revisit, if you are not familiar with Shanquella Robinson, she was murdered during a trip with what appeared to be her friends when they visited Mexico. And there's been a lot of investigations in terms of what really happened. And now the prosecutors in the United States are saying that they will not bring charges in what was previously a federal investigation into the death of Shanquella Robinson. Officials with the U.S. Attorney's Office in two districts in North Carolina, where Shanquella was from, announced this decision on Wednesday before Shanquella's family members were scheduled to speak about the probe and her killing at a televised news conference. And the U.S. Attorney's Office issued this quote, "The investigation into the circumstances surrounding the death of Miss Robinson has been a priority for federal prosecutors and the FBI. As in every case under consideration for federal prosecution, the government must prove beyond a reasonable doubt that a federal crime was committed. Based on the results of the autopsy and after a careful deliberation and review of the investigative materials by both the U.S. Attorney's offices, federal prosecutors, they have informed Miss Robinson's family today that the available evidence does not support a federal prosecution. This is very disheartening for me because it's very clear in the video footage that you see prior to her being officially dead that she was murdered. That's all it is as far as I'm concerned. Yeah. She was murdered by people who appeared to be her friends, and it wasn't like they went to a party and she just vanished. The video shows where they were beating her, physically beating her to her death. And this concerns me, Telly, because, again, this is a black woman who was traveling from the U.S. to Mexico with, again, what appeared to be her friends. And then they told the parents that she had died from alcohol poisoning. But the death certificate said later that she died as a result of a spinal and neck injury. They beat her that bad.
Gosh. And there's video out there that went viral.
Yes.
This is sickening. It's sickening, Denise, because...
And really quick. The authorities in Mexico... No, that's okay. I just want to say this to the listeners because this is so important to understand that when you travel with groups, number one, you better make sure without, what do they call it, a doubt that these are your friends. You can't travel with everybody. Also, when you go to Mexico, like right now, I think I'm going to put Mexico on pause because there's too many unresolved murders that basically come result in with either the Mexico authorities saying we're sorry or the U.S. authorities now saying we're not going to press charges. So remember, this was originally a murder that authorities in Mexico were investigating as a murder. Now, both Mexico and the U.S. authorities have said it's over. How do you think that makes the family feel? Like, Telly, think about it. How would you feel if a loved one that left to go on a vacation with what you believed were your loved ones or your daughter's friends to come back and first say, oh, she died from alcohol poisoning, and then all of a sudden the autopsy says she got beat to death, and so are the videos?
It's so disheartening because it really does show the lack of value in a young black lady's life that there's video. It's not like you're wondering what's going on or it's just you got to go off of the story that these so-called friends said about her having alcohol poisoning. My whole thing is you could see this was a setup because it wasn't like they were just over there kicking it and then like on the fourth day they got up and said, all right, we're going to beat her to death. Like this happened pretty much as soon as they got there. So you know it was premeditated. And then it sounds like their plan was executed to perfection because they're in a foreign country, and of course the laws and are different over there. And if you are not, you know, some famous or celebrity, or the daughter of a celebrity or something like that, you're just another case. You're just another murder case. And why am I going to put all these resources into something that these Americans came over and killed, you know, one American kills another American. So, like, if you're in Mexico, there's no connection to Miss Shanquilla Robinson. Absolutely.
They knew that. They knew that if we say we're going to Mexico for a vacation and we know we're going to kill her, we know we're going to beat her to death, there will be very little consequences to none. And now you've basically sent the message. And Shanquilla Robinson, beautiful woman, 25 years old. And what this sends to others is that you can get away with it.
Yeah.
That's exactly why I get so frustrated when there's so much publicity around these mass shootings, because those that are mentally ill, that do not care or value their life, they're like, well, I can go out with some notoriety, some celebrity. I don't want to live anyway. I'm going to go do some mass shooting, and I'll forever be in the history books of the U.S. Yeah. Because it's glorified. And this basically sends the message that, hey, you want to kill your friend? Take him to Mexico.
Yes.
There will be no consequences.
The family attorney for Sue Ann Robinson, Shaquilla Robinson's mom, had a quote, and this is, I mean, basically what we just said in a nutshell, Denise. United States citizens cannot go to Mexico, commit a crime that we all saw on video, and then come back to America and say, we're on base, we're safe. We're not going to be charged with a crime, she said. That cannot be the message that U.S. authorities want to send.
You know what, Telly? There's something behind the scenes that we just do not have.
Always is.
Because it's just like when Brittany Griner was held captive in Russia. I was like, there's just more in the background that we as Americans just we are not privy to.
It was so much. I mean, and not to go off on a tangent about the Brittany Griner thing, but okay, so Brittany Griner's been going over to Russia for approximately 8-9 years. Mm-hmm. So you mean to tell me this was the first time that she had a vape pen on her? Number one. Number
two. And the TSA people knew her. They liked her.
Exactly. Number two.
She had a relationship. Yes.
Number two, the professional team that she brought so much money, made so much money for in Russia. Wasn't it amazing that no one stepped up and said anything?
Mm-hmm.
And say, hey, this has been she's been a great citizen. She's been a model for our league for all these years. But as soon as they allegedly caught her with this, which I believe was all a setup because it was right around the time where Russia invaded Ukraine. And they knew that the United States would want to be involved, and they wanted a piece, and Brittany Griner was that piece, and she was a WNBA superstar.
And that's what I'm saying. There is you didn't even go off on a tangent. There is a correlation when it comes to American citizens, and in these cases, we're talking about specifically black women. Two black women, both Brittany Griner and Shaquilla Robinson. Thank goodness Brittany is alive and she was able to come back to the U.S. But there seems to be a trend of little to no regard for these lives.
Yeah, yeah.
And here's the thing. If it were a case where there was no footage, if this were a situation where she had vanished, she's missing, but the autopsy revealed that she died of spinal injuries and neck injuries. We saw the video. They originally, her friends, and I'm doing the air quotes, told her parents that she died from alcohol poisoning. 1 + 1 = 2, Telly.
Every time.
This is not rocket science.
Yeah. But when the math ain't mathing.
The math is not mathing, but what's even more disheartening, and I'll use the word disgusting, is that the U.S. authorities are not going, they're like case closed. So that means for the family that they will now have to live in grief with no closure. Do you know what type of impact that has on a person's emotional and physical well-being? These parents, her family members, her loved ones will never have closure.
Yeah.
Because they know that her killers are just walking around having a good old time while their daughter, their niece, their cousin is dead, and she will never come back. And all she wanted to do was go to Mexico with her friends and have a good time.
And we said this Friday is a feel-good Friday. The weather's good. It's 414 day. We weren't going to use the R word, but we know.
I forgot. This is truth be told.
We know it'll be a different story if this was another ethnicity. So I didn't use the R word, but we know what it would be if this was a different situation. And we also want to keep this conversation going, but we also want to make sure that you tune in to The Truth this Saturday at noon for Men Making Health a Priority, presented by All of Us Milwaukee at the Center for Community Engagement and Health Partnerships. Dr. Ken Harris will be joined by Dr. Bashir Easter and Caroline Nickerson, where they will celebrate science and promote the benefits of having a better understanding of science and technology. So be sure to listen to Men Making Health a Priority at noon Saturday, presented by All of Us Milwaukee and on the new 1017 The Truth, and be sure to keep it locked right here on Truth Be Told with DT and Telly, because we got more stimulating conversation when we return. This is 1017 The Truth, Telly Hughes, and the time is now, Milwaukee. Truth Be Told with DT and Telly is a show that's committed to creating a healthy space and dialogue every single morning for full transparency when it comes to issues and perspective through the African-American lens. So listen to Truth Be Told with me, Telly Hughes, every day from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. on the award-winning 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Hey, Truth fans, it's Dee Kemp, Vice President of Programs for Axe Housing. I am so excited to give you some information about how we can help you and your family reach the dream of owning your own home. At Axe Housing, we know you may be struggling to buy your own home due to financial strain, or maybe you don't even know how to get started on the path to home ownership. This is where Axe Housing can help. We will provide you with your own home buying coaching team who will help you with the entire home buying process from start to finish. That includes the home search, the loan process, and the big closing day on your dream home. Why rent when you can own? Here at Axe Housing, we help prepare families for successful home ownership. Stop paying rent and start building wealth. Reach out to our Axe Housing team today, because we believe in you and we know home ownership can be within your reach. Visit us today at axehousing.org to get started. That's axshousing.org.
Your first night camping alone. The new tent, fully set up. Your bug spray, barely keeping up. But you got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with free overdraft protection transfers. So when you bought all those supplies and lost track of your spending, we had you covered. You got this. With free overdraft protection transfers from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
When it comes to getting the smile of your dreams, you can't trust just anyone. So look no further than Bubon Orthodontics. Bubon Orthodontics is Wisconsin's number one Invisalign provider and have been providing the best value for braces and Invisalign since 1993. With 15 convenient locations, you're sure to find one in your area. Give the world your smile by scheduling a free consultation today. Call or text 262-522-7447 or visit bubonortho.com. Bubon Orthodontics, the official smile of the Milwaukee Bucks.
This is 1017 The Truth's Sherwin Hughes, and I am Milwaukee. This show has meant so much to me because it's an opportunity for me to express my thoughts and my feelings to my community, and for my community to express those same thoughts and feelings right back to me. Milwaukee means a lot to me. I was born here, raised here, educated here, and I'm committed to making this a better city. Join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations, where you can speak your truth. We are the new 1017 The Truth, Milwaukee, Black. Talk.
Truth Be Told with DT and Telly returns after this on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Boy, those are the smooth tunes that you want to go into your weekend with. And make sure you tune into the award-winning 1017 The Truth this Saturday at 1 p.m. for another episode of More Than a Movement, powered by Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin. Carrie Noni will be joined by health justice advocates to discuss Black maternal health and the impact it has on black birthing people. Again, that is More Than a Movement, powered by Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin, this Saturday at 1 p.m. on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth.
Well, if you are just tuning in, we've had some great conversations regarding this beautiful 414 day here in Milwaukee. We talked about spring break. Now, Milwaukee, we know that our summers are the best. However, there are going to be a number of us that as we prepare for summer, we're going to be traveling. So Telly and I, we want to bring some things to your attention to help you make sure that your travel is not only fun, but it's also safe. So there was a recent article published by the Washington Post that says the FBI, the Federal Bureau of Investigations, has made it known that public phone chargers may put your data at risk. So we know that when we travel, one of our top priorities, Telly, is to make sure our phones have juice.
Yes.
Well, there is a new term, if you have not already heard, it's called juice jacking. And juice jacking happens when, you know how we are, our phone gets on that red battery status, it's 20% or lower, and we start panicking because we know if we do not have our smartphones working,
we're going to shrivel up.
The FBI is warning that juice jacking is a cybercrime in which a hacker will use public USB ports to, yes, take your data from your phone, including credit card numbers, and they will also, through that same transmission of taking your data, stealing your data, they're going to also, ready for this, Telly, install malware on your device.
Wow.
And that's basically where they're going to be able to see your browsing history.
Yep.
They're going to be able to see your text messages, any type of personal communication that you have, pictures. That's right, pictures. And here's the big one, because I know I use this on my phone, wallets. So a lot of us will have our, you know, our credit cards or debit cards digitized so that we can use them through
airline
Pay
tickets,
or Apple Pay, airline tickets, all that.
Yep.
So bottom line, do not use free charging stations in airports, hotels, or shopping centers. The advice is from the FBI, carry your own charger and your own USB cord and use an electrical outlet to power up your device. Do not use the free charging stations in the airport. Now, here's an indicator that you're about to be juice jacked. If you, and now no folks going to give me some heat on this because I can only speak as an iPhone user because I have an iPhone. Droids, I love you to death. Just bear with me.
She just ain't green, y'all.
Now, see, every time you go get me in trouble, Telly. Here's the deal. When you plug your phone in, if you have an iPhone, it will ask you, do you trust this computer? If you do that on a public device and it comes up, do you trust your computer? You need to immediately unplug your phone because that is basically what's going to kick off the juice jacking. You should not see that message when you plug your phone into a public charging station, whether you're in an airport, cafe, whatever public facility. Do not use it, because if you do receive that message, that means that you are about to be juice hacked. So again, stay away from public chargers. Carry a USB cord. Carry a public charger. Plug it up to an electrical outlet to power up your device so that you do not get juice jacked. Also, Telly, do you have your passport?
I do have my passport, yes.
Okay. Now, let me ask you this. Is it about to expire?
No, but my wife's has.
You looked up.
No, I think I got about 8 more years.
Okay, but your wife's?
But my wife's has, yes. We got to get on that.
Okay, so here's the thing, y'all. Passport wait times are worse than ever. And a lot of us are going to be planning on traveling, taking vacations in the summer. If you do not already have your passport, if you have not already applied for your passport, due to the months-long backlog, here's what you should know. The U.S. State Department is feeling the weight of the demand of travel. Because remember, once the pandemic, and I'll use the air quotes, was over, people were like, I'm ready to go outside and play, Telly.
Yeah.
And so the travel industry is booming, and the airlines are struggling, trying to, you know, pick up and catch up. But basically, travel spending totaled $93 billion as of February since 2019, which is 5% above the 2019 levels and 9% above the 2022 levels. That means people are still wanting to travel. Now, because the wait time is so long, it is recommended that if you are trying to get your passport, let's say you're trying to go to Europe and have a wine and chocolate filled European vacation, whatever the case is, this is what you should do. Number one, check your passport's expiration date. Find out when your passport actually expires. Because here's the thing, Telly, and my son, he had to learn this the hard way. If your passport expires 6 months from now, oh, I see you, Telly. I see your passport. If your passport expires 6 months from now and you're thinking, oh, I'm good. I've got the whole summer. Summer is from, you know, the end of May through early September. No, it doesn't work like that. Most countries will not accept your passport if it was within 6 months of the expiration date.
Wow. Didn't know that either.
A lot of countries require your passport to be valid beyond 6 months. So if your passport expires, let's say, what is 6 months from now? That would be October. Mm-hmm. And you're thinking, I'm covered for the summer? No, you're not. Number two, get all your paperwork together and be aware of the restrictions. So before attempting to renew or get a passport, make sure you have all your paperwork in order so that you do not create further delay. Fill out the necessary paperwork, get your passport photo. You can go to any convenience store like Walgreens, CVS, the post office. You've got to get your paperwork done. Now, expedited wait times are not exactly speedy right now. So if you are willing to pay for your passport to be expedited, be ready to pay at least $60. And even for expedited passports, y'all, we're looking at 5 to 7 weeks. So if you're looking to travel in the summer, you need to get an expedited passport because it's either about to expire or you don't have it. You should probably do it now if you want to travel in the summer. There are emergency options. So you can get a life or death emergency service or urgent travel service passport. You can choose a life or death emergency service if you have an emergency that requires you to travel abroad within 3 business days. If you have non-emergency international travel plans within 5 business days, you can opt for the urgent travel service. Now, Telly, even if your passport isn't expiring soon, they say just renew it. So let's say your passport isn't going to expire until 2025. You should probably start now.
Gotcha.
With renewing it.
I'm good. So I just looked at mine. I'm 2028, so I'm good. Right?
Oh, yeah. You straight.
Okay. But
I would say as of 2026.
Go ahead and get on that.
Go ahead and get on it. Because the State Department, as much as they're trying to hire more people to make up for the increase in passport applications and renewal demands, there's just no way to keep up, and they have no idea when they're going to be able to go back to normal in terms of stopping the delays of passports. And again, get your passport, y'all.
Yeah. Get out, see the world.
The majority of the world looks like us. Did you realize that? As much as we hear the term minority, 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 let me tell y'all, black and brown folks in Milwaukee, you better believe we're the majority of the population in this thing called the world, the earth.
Yeah.
And I travel all the time. I travel all over the world all the time. You can visit my IG, Real Calm Coach. And every time I travel, it is so refreshing to know that aside from Europe, and actually in Europe, because you have Spain, you're going to see some people that look like you, but we are the majority, y'all. Recognize that. Do not let the term minority, because I don't like that word either, because the word minor alone is an association of being less than or insignificant. I do not use the word minority to describe people of color. But let me remind you, I do not, and we are not the minorities.
Right, yeah.
Truth Nation. Yeah. Even if you're not a person of color, understand this. People of color are the majority in this world.
Yeah.
Period.
And the only thing Denise is trying to do, Truth Nation, is get y'all ready. Get y'all set, making sure that once the summer hit, you can't be like, oh, man, I didn't know or wasn't sure. We trying to get you straight for it so you can plan your summer vacations, because the last thing you need is to plan a bunch of stuff and then realize you can't go because your paperwork ain't right.
Exactly. And, Tilly, I will just say this to you. The biggest misconception is that, you know, I can't, it costs too much money to travel. No, it doesn't. You know, it's interesting, Telly. I was thinking about this yesterday. There's a lot of protests going on in Paris right now. And I visited Paris when the Milwaukee Bucks played in Paris for the NBA.
I remember that. Yeah.
Yep. That was in two. That was right before COVID. Uh-huh. And they were protesting when I was there. And I thought to myself, do you see how sometimes the media will put fear in people's minds just based on imagery? Because looking at the news, you would think just based on the images that Paris is dangerous. I promise you, I was in Paris when they were protesting in 2019. Now, could I get an Uber? No, it wasn't that easy. But when I was there, I saw the protest, but I still had a great time. Mm-hmm. Went to Moulin Rouge, had dinner at the Eiffel Tower, went to the Louvre, saw the Mona Lisa portrait. I mean, do not believe the hype, in the words of Chuck D.
Right.
Don't believe the hype. Get your passport, travel the world, experience diversity, experience people that look like you. Because again, Truth Nation, black and brown people, we are the majority, period. We're the majority. Get your passport.
Yes, yes, absolutely. And get out there. See the world. See what this world has to offer. There's nothing wrong with that. The biggest gift that you can give someone else is exposure.
Yes.
Exposure.
You know, I had a passport since I was 6 years old, Telly. My mom did not play that. Well, you know, she's Guyanese anyway, so we always had to have a passport to travel, but the earlier, the better.
Yeah, yeah. You have to. You have to get out there. And you also have to stay locked in, because we'll have more on the other side of the break. This is Truth Be Told with DT and Telly.
Concordia University invites you to an evening with two American heroes, Father Robert Sirico, founder of the Acton Institute for the Study of Religion and Freedom, and Mr. Robert Woodson, founder of the Woodson Center. They'll present topics concerning the common good of society, how to address poverty, bring racial and social reconciliation while engaging in audience dialogue. The event is free at Concordia University and benefits the Milwaukee expansion of the Self-Reliance Clubs. Register at cuw-hope.eventbrite.com.
How you use and manage your credit has a big impact on your ability to buy a home and build wealth. Do you know if you're using your credit wisely? Find out by attending the Chase Coffee and Credit Program, hosted by Greater Milwaukee Urban League. Join us Saturday, April 29th from 10 a.m. to noon at Greater Milwaukee Urban League's office, 435 West North Avenue. Visit tmul.org to register for more information. Get your credit ready and start building your wealth today.
Did you know half of all cats in the United States don't see a vet on a regular basis? Hi, I'm Kat Dennings, and I love cats. Like, really, really love them, seriously. That's why I'm here to ask you to take your cat to the vet each and every year. I'm working with Royal Canin and Orphan Kitten Club in their program, Mighty Cat, the first grant program in the world to protect and care for newborn kittens. For the Take Your Cat to the Vet initiative, which encourages cat owners across the country to schedule annual vet visits. Since it's tricky to decode our cat's behavior, it is super important to collaborate with your veterinarian to uncover any potential illnesses and learn the signs that something could be wrong. As pet owners, it is our responsibility to make sure cats of all ages have a chance to live a full and happy life by providing the care they need and deserve. Visit orphankittenclub.org/mightycat to learn more.
All right, folks, let's get started. Parents, thanks for coming. As many of you know, I'm Coach Mather. Tonight I want to talk about the season, of which I only have one expectation, that everybody gets stronger. When I say get stronger, I'm not referring solely to physical strength. Sure, we'll be in the weight room, we'll be running stairs, but we're also going to focus on developing mental toughness and grit, because those are the characteristics that allow us to achieve greatness both on and off the court. So how do we develop those things? By getting comfortable with a challenge, by cultivating the confidence necessary to overcome adversity in all forms. That's why I coach. That's my purpose. Every member of this team can lean on me, and I'll teach them how they can lean on themselves and each other.
This message presented by the WIAA and the Wisconsin Athletic Directors Association.
We've just got some backups now. Northbound on 41 from about Blue Mound up past Swan Boulevard. An extra minute or so onto your ride. The other heavy spot is going to be on 43 northbound from about Silver Spring up past Bender Road. On and off the brakes there, we're looking at 13 minutes to get from downtown to Brown Deer Road. That is going to be an extra couple minutes onto your normal ride. And checking the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast today, mostly sunny, a high of 73 at the lakefront, 82 inland. Tonight, mostly clear, a low of 53. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga on 101.7 The Truth.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 101.7 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Brandon Snide. Behind a Rowdy Tellez two-run home run in the first inning and a sacrifice fly in the top of the 10th inning, the Brewers go on to win in San Diego, beating the Padres by a final score of 4-3. Colin Ray, who got the spot start for the Brewers, was the story of the game, going 5 2/3 innings while only giving up one earned run and striking out six batters. The Brewers are back at it tonight in San Diego. Eric Lauer is slated to start. First pitch is set for 8:40. Over to the NBA, where the Milwaukee Bucks are gearing up for their playoff run as they await the winner of tonight's play-in game between the Chicago Bulls and Miami Heat. Winner of that game moves on to Milwaukee for a Sunday afternoon tip beginning at 4:30 at Fiserv Forum. This sports update is brought to you by Associated Bank, proudly supporting your hometown teams. Member FDIC.
Truth Be Told with DT and Telly returns after this on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
It's only at the top, and whatever you do, you always gotta watch all the people around you. Nobody's invincible, no plan is foolproof. We all must meet our moment of truth. The same shiesty cats that you hang with and do your thing with could set you up and wet you up. Peep the language, it's universal. You
tune
play with fire and it hurts you.
101.7 The Truth this Saturday at 11 a.m. for our new show, Diversity and Excellence, powered by Erie Insurance and hosted by Dr. Ken Harris and Fred Johnson, the Vice President and Wisconsin State Manager for Erie Insurance. Dr. Ken and Fred Johnson will discuss what the Erie difference is, why more than 90% of their customers stay with Erie Insurance, and what sets them apart from the rest. So again, don't miss Diversity and Excellence, powered by Erie Insurance, this Saturday at 11 a.m. on the new 101.7 The Truth.
Telly.
Yes, ma'am.
You know, we've been talking about what we're doing this weekend, and you know, I know you're going to be traveling this weekend, so you're not going to be able to take advantage of 414 day, maybe PM activities, but definitely not the day activities.
Right.
And as we were covering the many, many celebrations and activities that are taking place in Milwaukee today for 414 day, you know, we were saying whether you're married or in a relationship or have kids, there's nothing you cannot do to have fun this weekend. And, you know, as a single black woman, I get a lot of heat in terms of, you know, why I'm single, what's wrong with me. And I just wanted to remind the ladies, the single black women out there, that although we've been conditioned to believe that the ultimate life goal is to find Mr. Tall, Dark, and Handsome, that's not necessarily the case for a lot of us now. Black women are continuing to change their mindset and prioritizing self-care. If you know Telly, the truth, we host a show called Soft Life Chronicles.
Yes.
And we just had an episode, I believe last weekend, that I had hosted. And it's really about black women now, black and brown women, reprioritizing. We've started to recalibrate, and we really are focusing on self-care, self-growth, and peace of mind. And we're doing these things because we really want, especially after the pandemic, we did a lot of reflection. We realized that we were not reaching our full potential because we were worried about everybody else. We were pouring into everybody else. We were taking care of everybody else. So here it is. The census.gov reports that marriage rates in the U.S. have been declining since the second half of the 20th century. Both men and women are increasingly waiting longer to get married. And the rate is significantly higher among black adults, particularly black women. So, in 1970, the population of never married women was made up of 27.7% black women and 35.6% black males. Nonetheless, these figures now, are you ready for this, Telly? They have increased to 51.4% for black males and 47.5% for black women. And again, you know, we've talked about this, you know, when I go home and my baby boomer dad and my traditionalist mother is like, what's going on? But people have to understand, black women especially were conditioned to take care of everybody. Whereas other women, other demographics, were conditioned to go to college and find a man. Black women traditionally are conditioned to go to college, graduate, get a degree, and get a good job. There's many variables that play into why there's such a significant amount of unmarried black women that are over the age of 35. But I also want to remind us that there are a lot of black women, including me, that enjoy being solo dolo. And there's absolutely nothing wrong, Telly, with being single. Now, I know you're married. You've been married, I believe you said 14 years with your wife, a total of 17?
Been married 17, been okay. With her a little longer than that. She don't like me to say how long because okay. It took me too long to get married, but we digress. Go ahead.
But here's the thing. I think that there is a lot of misconceptions regarding why there are so many single black women. You know, it's like, well, black women, they too this and they too that and don't nobody want them and they just too much. Please understand that black women are making a conscious decision to love ourselves and to treat ourselves and to explore things that are really about exuding self-love and self-care. Like tomorrow, I'm going to go out and get a massage. I'm going to have a little spa day for myself. And I've learned that as a woman who is single, that ultimately wants to be in a relationship with a man, creating happiness for myself is going to be so important before I can enjoy somebody else. And it doesn't have anything to do with me being anti-male, but I've realized that over the course of dating men, and I've even, you know, been married once, that I was seeking happiness and fulfillment from men, not loving myself, not appreciating myself, not taking care of myself. And that's ultimately what brought me to this state. I actually experience a lot of joy being a single black woman. I do, Telly. I experience a lot of joy. I really do.
Can I give you my opinion as to why more black women aren't getting married at an older age now?
Yes, well, not and older. before you do, let me, because I know this is going to open up the gates. The Truth Talking Text Line is 833-212-1017. We want this to be an engaging dialogue. So whatever Telly says, ladies and men, call in, text. The Truth Talking Text Line again is 833-212-1017. Yes, Telly, why do you feel that so many black women today are single?
Because y'all make y'all own money. There isn't that dependence on men as much as being the breadwinners. And I mean, like you said, you're good. You're good. You make your own money. You do the things that you like to do that makes you happy. I just don't think that there's a need or just that want to have, you know, a husband, three kids, the white picket fence. I don't think that's the dream anymore.
I so disagree.
I don't know. So you still think that's the dream? That's not your dream. Is that still your dream?
But Telly, because this is why there are so many single black women. Because a lot of brothers, it's not even about race. A lot of men look at women, such as myself. I'm an entrepreneur. I would definitely consider myself a successful entrepreneur. However, I work really hard at it. But that doesn't mean I don't need a man. I definitely need a man. I need a man. I want a man. I love men, and in particular, black men. And I'm so glad you brought that up, Telly, because I struggle with not dimming my light, not dimming my success, not dimming what I love to do so that I could be attracted to a man. That's not fair.
It's not fair, but if you give out these extra strong vibes that you don't need a man, that...
I said I need a man!
Yes, I mean, but maybe you... like. But see, the first part of solving a problem is identifying it. And you've identified that you have a tough time dimming your light. And I mean, because, and that is, and in all fairness to you, that is probably an extremely tough line to tote, because you do have to be this strong, independent woman, because it is you, but you don't want
but I don't
want to
be strong,
like, but you exactly.
I don't want to be strong. I want to be a delicate, yes, soft flower.
You
want to
be,
my
man. You want to be vulnerable to someone.
And submissive. I have, yes, no problem being submissive. Submissive is not about anime eat the cake. Submissive is I want to provide my man peace, rest, security, love, encouragement, support, unconditionally. That to me is being submissive. I have no problem being submissive to my man. But I don't dim my light. I'm like Mary J. Blige. Take me as I am or I have nothing at all.
Yeah.
And I know whoever God has for me will love me completely. And so I'm just saying, though, but why is it that so many men view single black women that are successful? Like, here's the reality. I need a man. Do I need somebody, anybody, to pay my bills? No. But I definitely need
the companionship.
A good man.
Yes,
absolutely.
The companionship.
The support, the encouragement, the protection.
Yes.
All that. I can't do that for me.
Yeah. And as much as, you know, how great traveling is usually better when it's somebody that you're with that you want to be. Well, I mean, if it's something you really, somebody you want to really be with, I think that could make the trip a little better, Denise.
I disagree, but I mean, here's the thing.
I mean, but what I really want to say, I really can't say it on air because,
I hear you on that. I feel you on
that. You could do with somebody else that you can't necessarily do by yourself.
I disagree with that too, but that's a whole other conversation off the air.
Yeah.
Bottom line is this. I was very deliberate about dating myself, traveling by myself, just really getting to know me. So that way, when God does send me the man that he has for me, he's not going to feel the pressure of, I got to like rebuild this woman. I got to like make her whole. I already am, baby. You're going to just compliment us.
Yeah,
as a union.
But let's go to the other side, and we can definitely get more of this on the other side of the break. Now, you're dating yourself and you're going to all these different things. The last thing a man needs is when we are going all these places, you're like, oh, I'd already been here. Nobody wants to hear that, Denise.
I would never say that.
All right.
That's
not out loud.
We're going to talk more about this.
Yes, we will. We'll have more, Truth Be Told, with DT and Telly on the other side of the break when we wrap things up on this fantastic Friday.
Milwaukee Black Talk.
I firmly believe that some of these fatal shootings would not be fatal shootings if we had more black paramedics and EMTs. And I ain't got no proof, I ain't got no evidence, but I firmly believe. But if an EMT or a paramedic, a white one from the suburbs, that's on their fifth response to a shooting victim, I think they're letting some of us die. I'm serious. I think, he's flatlined, still got a pulse. Oh, yeah, there's nothing we can do for him.
Listen to The Truth with Sherwin Hughes every weekday from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m.
Your first date? Going well. The carnival? Cash only. But you've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you, with access to over 30,000 surcharge-free ATMs. So when you decide to win that giant stuffed purple raccoon at $5 a throw, we're looking out for you. No matter how many throws it takes. You've got this. With 30,000 surcharge-free ATMs from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all. It's not just a slogan, but the way of life at Gruber Law Offices. If you've been injured, call our team today. We've represented tens of thousands of injured Wisconsinites for more than 30 years. Trust Wisconsin's own Gruber Law Offices, proud partner of your Milwaukee Bucks. One call, that's all.
Locked inside every Wisconsinite is a unique code shaped by genetics, environment, and lifestyle. This code makes you uniquely you and holds clues to your predisposition to certain illnesses like diabetes, cancer, or depression. When you join the All of Us research program, you help researchers study ways to improve healthcare and receive health information that matters to you. Learn more. Visit allofus.wis.edu or call 888-294-2661. Answers are in all of us.
What is dedication?
My biggest fear in the middle of my addiction was that my kids wouldn't have a father. I overdosed on heroin, and I lived. And I started thinking, you know what? This isn't my story. My desire to change had finally outweighed my desire to stay the same. I felt powerless for so much of my life. It's important to me that my kids are empowered and truly believe that if they can think it, they can do it. I definitely had to become a better man to be a better father. For the first time, I finally feel like I'm exactly where I should be, where I want to be.
That's dedication. Visit fatherhood.gov to hear more. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
Truth Be Told with DT and Telly returns after this on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
And Mary cannot dance, but
man,
she can
do
bob.
That dance one more time.
She can bob though.
Man, yeah, Mary retired that. Shout out to Mary J. Blige, one of the greatest of all time.
Oh gosh, that
this
album.
Is yes, all time, my life. You are listening to Truth Be Told, or as Madi says, the butt naked truth. Madi is like butt naked truth. So you're listening to Truth Be Told, also known as the Butt Naked Truth with DT and Telly, on the new 101.7 The Truth, coming to you live from the American Family Insurance Studio inside the Avenue in the heart of downtown Milwaukee. Telly, this has been such a great show. I'm so excited for the weekend to be here. It's 414 Day in Milwaukee. There's so many great activities that are going to be happening today. The weather is awesome.
Yes, yes.
Single ladies, we were talking about being single. and not having to dim your light. And Telly was basically saying to me off the air that I'm going to have to find, or no, because I'm not finding no man. He going to find me, okay?
Right. I didn't say that. Yeah, I didn't say find. Well, no. Did I? I think I did use the word find. You're right.
Everybody does egg. Yeah. When I find a man, I'm not looking. Like, yeah. He's going to find me.
Yeah. But no, I was saying.
I'm going to wake up one morning and Justin Timberlake. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Yes, I'm glad I interrupted that.
Right.
As soon as I heard Justin Timberlake, let me go ahead.
He's light-skinned, Telly, so let me don't even.
No, I wasn't going to say that. I was just saying that, Denise, I did use the word fine, but find someone that has the same mentality and mindset that she has. That's what I was saying. Not go out and find a man, put on your go get him dress and go get him girl dress and all
did
that.
Did you say go get him? Telly, you sound so old right now.
Get him,
girl. Nation, did y'all hear Telly? He said put on your go get him dress. Telly, I tell you what. I am going out this evening to meet a friend, and I will not be saying, girl, I'm about to go up here and put on my go get him.
You know what? No, don't call me out.
Don't ever repeat that again in life.
Don't wait until we're almost off the air to talk about this this outing that, you know, I've done a really good job.
I'm going to meet a friend. I didn't say anything. Y'all ought to see Telly's face. Go ahead, Telly.
No. You know what? Denise,
I'm a
girl.
Single woman.
You my sister.
I'm a single woman.
I would never put your business out there.
Listen, I was going
to
save it because,
time.
Of course,
yes.
I am a single woman. I am dating. I'm having a great time. I work very hard all throughout the week. And so if a nice gentleman invites me to hang out and have a good time, platonic
there
good
it
time
is.
Let me be clear, then of course I'm going to,
and I think you
and
should.
I'm not gonna put on no go get him dress on. That, you tell it, you are hilarious. You can tell you've been married and out the game for like centuries.
Hey, no, don't
Denise,
act like I'm
go
old
out there and put your
and decrepit, you know what
when
I mean?
It comes like, to dating, you are,
I mean, well, yeah,
go get him dress, go get him, D. You go out there and get him. Yeah, go get him. That's not what we put on, Telly. I am not going to be putting on no go get him dress on.
Before we get out of here, Nay hit us up on the talking text line. Always be a part of our discussions on Truth Be Told with DT and Telly at 833-212-1017. She said, greetings and happy Friday, y'all. And big ups to you, Sister DT, for engaging in your self-care. Think of me the next time you desire your complimentary relaxation and stress relief massage. I meant complimentary. Hey, Nay, I want some of that too. We need self-care too. What's up? Come on, Nay.
Nay, thank you so much. I love you back, sister. I definitely will take you up on that complimentary relaxation and stress relief massage. And I guess I'll bring Telly because he over here looking like somebody stole his bicycle.
Yeah, I want some. No,
Telly, you cannot ask for a free anything after you said go put your go get him dress on, okay? I need you to work on that.
Yes,
that's
I can.
Your
and you the only one that keep bringing that up.
Because I give you a hard time. That's right, honey. You go upstairs and put your go get him dress on. You're going to crush it tonight.
Well, forget the go get him dress. Denise, you go and have a great weekend, my sister. And Milwaukee Truth Nation, you have a great Friday and great weekend as well. 414 Day, holla back. This has been Truth Be Told with DT and Telly. Sherwin Hughes is up next.
Bringing all the smoke to you.
I love what you're doing, and this radio station is just like what it's called. It's the truth.
Download the new 101.7 The Truth app now. Milwaukee Black Talk. 101.7 The Truth.
Truth Nation, just press play. Your favorite award-winning 101.7 The Truth is launching our brand new video stream this Friday. Watch live on The Truth's Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook pages. Just press play this Friday for the home of Milwaukee Black Talk.
This is Dr. Ken Harris from Truth in the Afternoon. Listen to The Truth all day, every day by downloading the Truth app or streaming on Spotify, TuneIn, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, or Stitcher. Milwaukee Black Talk. 1017 The Truth.
This is Melanie Ricks from Nothing But The Truth. If you love to be both entertained and informed, make sure you listen to The Truth all day, every day by downloading The Truth app or streaming on Spotify, TuneIn, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, or Stitcher. 1017 The Truth, Milwaukee Black Talk.
On Diversity and Excellence powered by Erie Insurance, I am so excited to talk about the different ways that Erie Insurance can help with our community growth, can provide job opportunities from Erie Insurance Corporate, or with our local agency force. I'm really excited about the education of generational wealth in our Black and Brown communities and how we are a part of the communities here locally. There's so much more we can be a part of. Listen to me, Fred Johnson, on Diversity and Excellence, powered by Erie Insurance.
This is your Financial Empowerment Minute on the new 101.7 The Truth, presented by Northwestern Mutual.
The other thing that we should be thinking about is diversifying and getting money outside of your business. And so when we think about that, starting small, a Roth IRA is an easy account that you can open on your own. You can open with an advisor and you can contribute up to $6,000 a year into a Roth IRA. And then if you're over 50, you can contribute $7,000 a year into that. If you want to contribute more money, you can open a SEP IRA. And these are good if you don't have any employees, right? If it's just you, the contribution limits are higher. And then if you start to have employees, then you can think about starting with a 401k. All of these options are gonna be based on your situation and how much money that you're bringing in, but there's still a lot of different options out there that can accommodate you and your situation where you are.
Tune into The Truth every month for our financial empowerment interviews with Northwestern Mutual.
Ready for our little forest adventure?
Yes!
There's a forest closer than you think. Find a park or forest near you and music inspired by nature at discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by USDA Forest Service and the Ad Council.
The Bloomberg Black Business Beat is presented by Erie Insurance, providing the protection you need and the service you expect, all at a great price.
Milwaukee's Black Talk lives here. You are listening to 101.7 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha, and W269DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station.
This is the Bloomberg Black Business Beat. A growing number of single people are ready to call it quits when it comes to dating. The Pew Research Center found that 63% of single and looking adults say dating has only gotten harder since pandemic lockdowns. Couple that with a Black population with growing spending power, and you've got a lot of people finding themselves in a new social category: middle class, single, and living alone. That comes with stigmas, especially for Black women, who might feel like they need to choose between pursuing a career or finding love. Dr. Chris Marsh is associate professor at the University of Maryland and just put out a book that explores what it means to be a Black single professional. She talked to Bloomberg about how she wants Black women not to feel pressured into being in a relationship.
There are people that are single, they're very happy in their singlehood, and they're learning how to live full lives and have wonderful lifestyles. So let's talk about their lifestyles. Let's not leave the conversation at, why aren't you married? Why don't you have any children?
Dr. Marsh's book, The Love Jones Cohort, is out now. I'm Bloomberg's Justin Milliner on the Black Business Beat.
The following conversation brought to you by Omega, 800-300-9ERC. That's 800-300-9372. OmegaTaxCredits.com.
I thought I couldn't get the ERC if I got the PPP loan.
Nope. If you're a business owner with 5 to 500 employees, you might be eligible.
I thought it was really difficult to apply for the ERC.
Not if you use Omega. See, Omega is an accounting firm that has been around for over 15 years. They are a true accounting firm that will have a fiduciary relationship with you and your business, and they don't get paid until you get paid.
But I'm sure it takes forever to find out if you're eligible.
Again, no. If you call 800-300-9372, you...